Good girl, Willow. Good girl.
Lay.
I see you.
Lay down.
Oh,
lay down.
Lay down.
Lay down.
All right. We miss her, don't we, guys?
Okay, guys. First question is to whoever wants
Jacob.
No, wait.
Oh, she's in charge. Go ahead.
Could you spell your first and last name, please?
My name is Sabrina Casper, and my first name is spelled S-A-B-R-I-N-A, and Casper C-A-S-P-E-R.
You can call it. Now you can just call him.
I think Jacob was first. Jacob, we'll let you go first.
So, do you have any memory of fifth graders leaving to go to middle school?
The year that Clear Creek was opened, are we talking about, or just any year?
Like, when you first came here, do you remember any, did you guys see any fifth graders? What did they do?
The only thing that I remember the first year was is that we talked as a staff, the teachers talked, because we wanted to do something special for the kids as you leave. And I know some of you probably remember this, watching the big kids do it in other years, right? So we talked about going ahead and doing some kind of a, like as you exit the building for the last time, we do that whole big cheer thing where we clap for you. And it actually started out as a tunnel, where we made a tunnel and all the kids tried, and then the fifth graders ran underneath it as you walked out of the building. So that was started the first year because we wanted a special tradition that we could do every year. And we've done it for 20 years, so that's pretty cool, huh? Another question.
In your opinion, do you think it's a good thing that we've had 5 principals over 20 years?
Whew, say how many we've had. That's right. Boy.
So we've each been here for 4 years.
No, not quite. If you averaged it, it would be 4 years, but it's not quite how it works out. You know, in a way, change is good, but it is sort of sad that we lose them. I mean, I kind of like getting to know somebody and working for them a long time. But, you know, change is part of life, guys. You know, I've had, in fact, Dr. Fry and Ms. Ordehoff technically as my superiors here. They are my 22nd and 23rd administrator in my 35 years of teaching. So I've had that many bosses in my lifetime, in my teaching career. So that's a lot of change. And so it's just part of it. It's just part of the job.
Yes.
Can I go to my notebook?
Sure.
Totally.
Yes, sir.
What was a popular movie in 1997?
Oh my gosh, well let me get out my Google, because that's how I'm going to find out. I don't know that I can remember that right off the top of my head.
Crystal, can you remember?
It is. It's not hard. It's okay. It's a good topic. I just can't tell you that without looking at this. Can you tell me the movie that was the big movie or your favorite movie the year you were born?
No.
No. See? So it's the same thing, right? It's the same
thing.
All right, another question for you.
So, do you know how many years, so each principal, they've had a certain year that they've been here. Do you know which one has had the longest years that they've been a principal?
Boy, you know, I think probably Mrs. Handy was here the longest. And she was what was called at that time our learning coach, and then the job became assist, like Mrs. Werderhoff is our school improvement instructor, whatever, what's it called, specialist, whatever. But yeah, the job has changed a little bit. We didn't have a vice principal at first, and then we had learning coaches, and then it changed to a school improvement specialist a couple years ago. So yeah, probably, I think Mrs. Handy was probably here the longest of anyone. Another one?
How does it feel to see all of your kindergartners like grow up?
Well, sometimes it's sort of sad. That's why I like to be part of that little tunnel thing, or not quite the tunnel thing, but the congratulation thing when you walk out. And we always like to go out and wave to the kids in the buses. Long time ago, everybody was a bus rider, and we had very few car riders. And so that was always a big thing. The teachers would go out, and we would wave to the kids in the bus. And of course, sometimes we were waving because it was like, yay, it's summer! And then sometimes we were crying because, you know, certain groups touch your heart more than others. So I don't know if you guys know this, but you are my by last class of AM and PM. Mm-hmm. You were the last class that I taught before I started teaching full-day kindergarten. So you guys were, if you had me or another teacher here, you were either an AM or a PM kindergartner. So kind of fun. But
what do you think your overall thoughts about teaching of the year is?
Oh, my overall thoughts. Well, after doing this for more years than some of your mom and daddies are old, I still get up every day and I can't wait to get here. I'm not a perfect teacher. I make mistakes, but I hopefully grow and learn from them. And I still love doing what I do. So that's how I feel about it. It's the best job ever. It doesn't pay a lot, but it's enough. You know what? You can always live, right? Another question?
How come you decided to stay as a kindergarten teacher for 35 years?
Well, you know what? I haven't been a kindergarten teacher for 35 years because I was a second grade teacher for 12 years. That's where I started off. So I was a second grade teacher for 12 years. And I never really thought about doing upper grades, but as I've taught, I've kind of thought, I think I can teach the upper grade. I think I'm pretty good. You know, I love science. I could really get into the science that you all get into as big kids. But you know, I think the reason that I moved to kindergarten, lots of reasons probably, but one reason was I love being able to keep the lamp of learning lit, I guess, is one weird, corny way of saying it. It's like, you know, little kids naturally love to learn. So my job is just to keep that going. When I taught second grade, I already had kids that would come into my classroom hating school. Or not like in school, I guess is the best way to say it, right? But I just, and that really touched me. I was like, oh, I hate that. So I spend a lot of time trying to show them that there is beauty in school and there is greatness, and if you just try, then you'll like school. So that was kind of hard for me, was to try to sway them back. So kindergarten's kind of fun because you get them all kind of fresh and you just go hit the ground running with them. And you're setting tones for them for the rest of their lives. You know, that's kind of nice to teach them about school and about how to get along with others and all that from the very beginning. It's kind of a big job. I can take it very seriously. Yes, sir?
What were popular songs? 1997.
Gonna have to get out my Google. You guys can do that, okay? You guys do that for me, all right?
You can say, what was
what's up? It's the same thing. It's his favorite movie.
I was gonna say, do the kindergartners, do they make you laugh a lot? Do they say,
yeah.
Like,
yeah, but sometimes you can't show it, you know? Which I know your teacher kind of has that too. But you all get humor, you know? I mean, in kindergarten, the best joke is, what do you get when you put cheese and crackers together? And you're like, okay, where's this one going, right? And it's like, cheese and crackers! And they just think it's hilarious! So they're just, you know, their humor hasn't quite developed yet, but that's funny to them. And, you know, to us, it's like, oh, that's a pretty lame joke. But they're fun, and they're silly, and that's what I like about them. So, what else? Yes, ma'am, or sir.
So,
sorry.
When you started teaching, I mean, why did you start teaching? Like, who influenced you in?
Great question. You know, when I was little, I grew up in the 60s. I was born in 1961, so yeah, you can figure out how old I am. In the 60s, the space era had started, and I wasn't the only one, but a lot of children wanted to be an astronaut. And that's what I wanted to be at first. I thought, I want to go to space, because all of us did. I mean, that was just sort of like the thing we all did. And then as I grew up, I figured out, okay, when I get on twirly rides, I get sick and throw up. And then I started figuring out other things about me and what I'm good at and what I'm not so good at. And I'm like, okay, now I don't know that I can be an astronaut. I'm not sure I'm brave enough to be an astronaut. So maybe I'll think of something different. So then I had to really take a good hard look at myself and say, okay, what am I good at? What are my strengths? What do I love? And you know what? At Thanksgiving dinner, I was always the teenager who wasn't sitting at the adult table. I was the teenager who was playing with the little kids in the family. I was singing with them. I was doing stuff, right? So I don't just love little kids. I like them. I like to hear how they talk. I like to learn from them. I like to mold them and shape them. And that's what makes me a teacher. So does that answer your question? Is that good? Okay. How about you?
Do you know why the school decided to have a vice principal position?
You know, I think they would always like, the district is actually, that's a district decision. I think they would always like to have a second management person in charge, but it's not always cost friendly. You know, we can't always afford two of those salaries. So, your question is why they would have one is because two brains are better than one, I guess. But I think that it's just always been a matter of money. And having a learning coach years ago when you guys were in kindergarten, it was a learning coach, and now having the SIS, the school improvement specialist, they are like Dr. Fry is a doctor, so he makes more money having a PhD in education, whereas Mrs. Werderhoff has a master's and all that, but not necessarily in administration. She's not a doctor, so she doesn't cost as much to have in our schools. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes.
How has the school changed since?
Oh gosh. It's a lot less colorful in the hallways. I was looking at my photographs last night.
I had a good time doing this.
We used to have a lot more color on our walls and things. And then they came through, I don't know, however long it took to get fresh paint. And they did a lot of just white walls. So that was kind of funny. They took a lot of the color off the walls. I have some pictures that show like how colorful the walls and the activity center used to be and different things. So they just made it a little bit easier. So how's it changed? Oh gosh, hundreds of ways. I had some funny things to share with you. When we opened 20 years ago, there was no playground equipment installed yet.
What do you mean?
The playgrounds were there, but there was no playground equipment. So our first few weeks of school, they were working on it. It had been ordered, and somebody was coming to put it up, but it wasn't there. So our first few weeks,
kindergarten one or that one?
None of them. The big kids or the kindergarten playground had no equipment the first few weeks of school. We just went outside and ran and played, and we took out some chalk and balls and whatever. So we may do. You know, that's what teachers are best at, right? Okay, wow, this is different. Let's do that. So you just have to kind of wing it, don't you? We didn't have any library books. All we had, I have to say this, we had some library books, just a few from Woodsonia, because Woodsonia is the school that, one of the schools that closed, that opened Clear Creek. And so we had a very few books that they donated to us, but not very many. So we didn't have very many books. We had no telephones. They weren't installed when the school was open. We didn't have an intercom system when the school was open. So it just took time to finally get all those things going. Did you know that the gym used to have carpet in it?
Yes. I saw that.
Yeah, it used to have carpeting in it. It was kind of cool. Let's see. Funny story about Clear Creek, too. When this school was being built, there was a woman who was in charge of the construction. And she was like the foreman or whatever you call her. And she was pregnant. And so halfway through the building of the school, she had her baby. And she went on maternity leave, right? Well, her counterpart that took over her place did not get the skinny on everything that might have been changed on the blueprints. And so if you'll go down to the kindergarten rooms, you'll see this little cubby hole in the one corner of each of the rooms. And the cubby hole I made into a coat closet just so I had extra coat hooks in my room. But the other teachers do different things, whatever, with it. But that hole shouldn't have been there. That little fake know-nothing wall shouldn't be there. But what it was supposed to be was the doors between those rooms, there should have been collapsible doors instead of walls. So you know those folding doors, kind of like we have in the gym between the stage, mm-hmm. right? They were supposed to be collapsible walls so that two kindergarten rooms could actually be opened up to be one big room, and it would be like a great big giant workspace for kids. So that didn't happen, and it didn't get told to the new foreman that wasn't going to happen. Uh-oh.
I like your ringtone.
That's my reminder. All right, here we go. Yes, Abby.
Before you were a teacher at Clear Creek, did you teach at Woodsonia, or did you teach?
Well, that's a funny story. I taught in DeSoto for 12 years.